listen to the ovation! There's nothing else like it. It is deafening, and rightly so.
2018 was the pinnacle of Team Lakay's achievements in mixed martial arts. Four concurrent world titles showcased their rapid growth in the sport. It was the culmination of years of hard work, indomitable warrior spirit and teamwork, with the resolve to pursue a dream.
One team, 1 year, apat na world champions. Talagang napakasaya. Para sa amin is history. Papasalamat nga kami kasi ngayon may picture-picture na eh. Ano, kahit na tatanda kami, pag nakita yun ng mga tao, maaalala nila.
The whole of Team Lakay have championship gold once again.
Yung sa part ko lang nung nakauwi na ako noon, after 1 week noon, tsaka lang nag-sink in sa akin na nakuha pala natin to. Meron pala to nung nasa bahay na ako, na hindi ko ma-explain, na sabi ko na totoo ma to. Hindi ka lang mong nananaginip ako nung nakuha natin yung apat na belts. Yung 2018, ang golden moments ng Team Lakay.
But the world of martial arts is ever evolving. There are new challenges to confront, contenders to oppose, and hungry talents vying for the crown. 2019 proved to be a tough year for Team Lakay. Two belts were lost in January, with two more 2 months later. By the end of March, the elation of 2018 was no more.
Oh, masakit man, pero kailangan tanggapin. Ang daming natutunan ng team doon sa hindi naging magandang pasok ng 2019 sa amin. Yung bawat atleta sa iba't ibang division, tinatry din nilang mag-improve at maging mas magaling na martial artist. Nakita nila kami yung tinitingnan nila, so yun yung gusto nilang isurpass, yun nagawa naman ng iba.
We have to move forward. That's the thing we always talk in the gym. If we stay in here, we will maintain the sorrow, then we will live the rest of our life with regrets. The good thing is we motivate one another. Time to stand up, time to move forward. Let us look and assess which thing we went wrong. We keep developing.
Three of the four belts were held by Team Lakay members in their 30s. While many of the criticisms were overstated, there was no denying that for Team Lakay to keep pace with the elite of the sport, new talents needed to be developed.
Lakay Championships, meron kaming MMA, meron kaming Grappler's Cup, and meron kaming yung kickboxing din. Pinipilit namin yung mga members, yung mga different gyms ng Team Lakay na makiparticipate, competing sa mga ibang clubs din. Pinipilit natin na magkaroon ng ganito, exposure sa mga atleta natin para mapadali yung growth ng mga atleta natin para pagpunta nila sa international level, composed na sila pag maglaro. Marami akong next na nakikita doon na nung nag-compete sa Team Lakay Championship na pwedeng susunod mga next generations.
I also tried once competing in Team Lakay Championship. Experience is very good. It will really make you a better martial artist.
2019 was the emergence of a new generation of Team Lakay athletes making an impact on the global stage. Young phenom Joshua Pacio reclaimed his one strawweight world championship in a rematch.
Pag nag-champion ka kasi, hindi mag-end dun. Yung hard work na ginawa mo, kailangan mo pang i-double to remain and still champion. Belt namin to, so yun nga. Kung wala sila, hindi naman ako mag-champion. Nung sila yung tumutulong sa akin, sa training, sa sparring, binubugbog nila ako para lang mag-stay na champion. O, ito na lang yung natitirang belt. Hindi ito yung end.
Joshua Pacio is really a champion because he's willing to learn. Always he wants to learn, always he researches his opponent, and he wants new techniques every time he came into the gym. I know that Joshua will dominate 2020 in his division.
Danny Kingad made it to the championship final of the One Flyweight World Grand Prix, with only the greatest mixed martial artist, Demetrius Johnson, denying him the belt.
Look at this. Here's DJ getting that front headlock position. Tries to soften Kingad up with a little bit of knees to the face. Beautiful snap down there as he floats around Kingad. Normally these spins and these transitions creating these scrambles work for Kingad, but DJ's just one step ahead in the scrambling exchanges to maintain that position.
Demetrius Johnson!
Danny is very special because this guy is very strong physically and mentally. He had been through a lot of adversity, but he was able to choose the right path. I think there's a lot more of things in store for him. Just needs a lot of sharpening for him to be a champion someday. I'm expecting that Danny will be able to showcase a better year this 2020, especially that he faced a legend in DJ.
Aking goal talaga na maging world champion. Si DJ, madami akong natutunan sa kanya. Yung spin niya, tapos yung talagang maluwag yung pag-isip niya sa pag nasa laro siya. Talagang gusto mag-rematch kami kasi ayun nga, binigyan ko siya ng magandang laro. I think ito na ang pagkakataon para matalo siya.
Lito Adiwang made a stunning debut in ONE Championship after dominating the competition in Rich Franklin's ONE Warrior Series.
Three consecutive wins on Rich Franklin's ONE Warrior Series catapulted him into the big time. And here he is on the biggest of big shows, ONE Century in Tokyo.
Then sa debut ko sa ONE is parang nakompleto ko na, ipakita ko rin yung ground game ko. Pinaghandaan ko kasi alam kong hometown ano siya, favorite. So parang yun rin ang isang nag-push sa akin para tapusin ka agad.
Lito Adiwang is very special because his style is very unique. He can knock you out and he can submit you. His last bout with Senso Akida is very impressive because they are not expecting a submission coming from him.
Lito Adiwang is a different kind of breed, a different kind of species. I expect him to keep winning in 2020.
Lakay means brother. And on the foundations of brotherhood, Team Lakay has forged its success. With much needed new blood, the original members must work harder than ever to maintain those values.
Yung core values ng Team Lakay, isa dyan yung attitude. Attitude ng mga atleta. Tapos yung andyan yung siyempre disiplina din. Humility din nila, kailangan yun. And passion. Ang ganda ng samahan and yung mga values ng mga atleta natin yan, especially sa Team Lakay, masyado silang disiplinado at very humble. Kailangan na yung hindi mawala yung core values na yung team para susunod yun hanggang sa next generation.
Team Lakay sits at a crossroads with the pioneers that have brought it unparalleled success, looking to make a final charge at greatness. While a new generation of hungry young talent has shown they are ready to take the reins. 2020 will reveal the path, but whatever the direction, change has already begun.
Sa year 2020 for Team Lakay, yes, tingin ko mas kumpiyansa na yung mga atleta natin ready ulit to get their belt back.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.